say the universe, it works in a strange way. And it must be true because we ain't from the same background or same place. But me and Lesley ended up on that same train. I'm talking every day. I used to wake up around 7 or 8 to catch the 906 from Norbury Station. Two different worlds in the same location. And one day we ended up speaking. And I would talk about college, she would talk about meetings and how she's planning on leaving. How she hates what she does but she needs it. I asked her what she would do when it's the weekend. And she said, I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. She used to be the life of the party for true. And now she's going out hardly ever. Her man got her in the yard forever. And her friends wanna help, but it's hard to tell her. Hard to let her know that her man's possessive and aggressive. And she can't even see it, but for them it's clear as day. She's in a situation. Her friend Hannah had a man that was manipulative. So she can see it from a mile off. Turtleneck jumpers, makeup around the eye spots. All the signs were there. But Lesley made it seem a light affair. Said it wasn't right to share. Her boyfriend, he was a mystery man. Didn't know much about him, but he's been in a can. Name's Jason, he's a bad boy with no reasoning. To be honest, I don't know what Les sees in him. Cause she's a good girl with a sweetheart. But they both got demons in a deep past. You know opposites attract, apparently. Never heard her talk about her family ever. He was all that she had. Until they had an argument and he stopped calling her back. And I don't know if there was more to the story than that. Cause she plays things down, but according to that, he went missing one day in the morning he ran. She's doing overtime, struggling, affording a flat. Till she lost her job, it fucked all of her plans. Couldn't pay the rent, borrowing and calling for cash. But Hannah, she was there for her, care for her. When I saw Les, she told me, I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. Les saying I got nothing to live for. It's been raw, but David, I ain't never been this poor. There's no income, my boyfriend left me. So how the fuck am I gonna survive when his kid's born? And I said it's a blessing, as mad as it is. And Les, I never even knew that you were having a kid. Bro, she's 4 months pregnant, young and neglected, single, but I don't think she wants to accept it. So she's still texting exes, trying to get this back on track, but I don't think that she gets it. Emotional obsession, clinical depression, life is a lesson. And you ain't gotta sit and cry. It's Lesley, living in this gift called life. There's no better gift than the gift of life. So can you handle it? I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. But that changed her perspective. Late in December, her baby's expected to drop. She's accepted, excited, electric, pumped. Only gotta wait a few months. Her and Hannah had lunch, told her she's pregnant. And they're the closest of brethren, so she didn't stunt to tell her. I think that it's an error. You ain't a mum for a day, you're a mum forever, whatever. And you and Jason break up whenever. If I'm honest, that's something you should have done together. She doesn't know that her and Jason going out again. And Jason doesn't know that Lesley's carrying a child for them. She had daydreams of settling down with Jason. Better cause now they're together, it's wild. Feeling like she needs to call her friends and tell them. Cause wow, she's letting them down, but most of them are never around. She calls Hannah the next day. Still trying to figure out the best way to tell her that she's getting back together with an ex-flame. So she left her a voicemail. Like, yo Hannah, it's Les, can you call me back? I wanna talk about the baby, you, me, Jason, all of that. I've been feeling like I need to get my aura back. I used to be so fucking confident, but these days, I swear that I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. It's 3:30, Lesley was meant to get a scan, but today I think she's going home early. Trying to talk to Jason, tell him about the kid, addressing any reservations. Have that conversation, middle of the summer and it's raining. Waiting at the train station, hella cancellation. So she gets a taxi, sitting in the backseat. Blue jean jacket and a maxi. Actually tired and her legs are aching. Touch the destination, way faster than a cab driver's estimation. She put the key in the door. She couldn't believe what she see on the floor. Some size 5 trainers, raging, tears in her eyes, but it's cool, cause they must be the neighbours. And Jason's in a bedroom, fully naked. Lesley running up the stairs, but she's making noise. And she can hear Jason's voice saying, hide in the closet, but he's made his choice, so she bursts in, saying, what kind of person would cheat on his pregnant girlfriend? Jason saying, what the fuck, you're pregnant, what the fuck? You weren't even gonna tell me, I mean, what the fuck? What do you want from us? Nah, you ain't in love, you just wanna love. Lesley telling Jason, I don't wanna love. I don't wanna you and I don't wanna us. And also, I don't wanna talk loads. One more line before I dash like Morse code, open the wardrobe. And Jason's on the edge. I just wanna see if she was prettier than me, slimmer than me. Maybe your baby similar to me. Maybe you wanted someone thicker than me, fitter than me, to satisfy you quicker than me. I got your baby in my stomach and you did this to me. What did I ever do to you for you to finish with me? I didn't believe my girls, but they were thinking of me. And give it to me, the wardrobe, give me the key. I was pulling at the door, but Jason's bigger than me. Literally, I remember viscerally, Jason pulling from behind me, now he's gripping on me. White flash, eye gashes when he's hitting me, see. I just wanted to disappear, I wasn't living for me. Physically, I shut the fucking door as quick as can be. He's outside asking why I made him do what he did. Using a kick to open up the room that I'm in. I'm feeling afraid, barricaded with a chair and a handle. I'm hearing sirens, I just wanna run away, but I can't. Jason's gone by the time police are coming. They saw that there ain't no one else in the house, and feds are running through the door shouting. We had reports of an argument with a woman. There's blood all over the floor and it's splattered onto the wall. There's Lee's on the bed and she's trying to speak to the feds. She's deep in the stress and there's meters above her head. If anything, she couldn't even say anything. But she's got this really sharp pain where her belly is so. They call her ambulance. Lesley didn't plan for this. Police are in the room trying to find a missing piece of the puzzle until they stumble on something that's kind of random. It's a phone in a wardrobe. They had 5 missed phone calls from Jason and also a couple other numbers, so they're thinking that it's no help. Until they play the voicemail, like, yo Hannah, it's Les, can you call me back? I wanna talk about the baby, you, me, Jason, all of that. I've been feeling like I need to get my aura back. I used to be so fucking confident, but these days, I swear that I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. She felt sick to her stomach, she started panicking. Mind rattling, trying to understand what Hannah did. Battling the shame, cause the situation embarrassing. She's trying to fathom it, betrayed by her own garrison. Meanwhile, she's on the deck trying to manage this. Piercing pain in her stomach, she couldn't handle it. Now she's waiting for an ambulance. Look. And I know she's strong, but when I heard about what happened, I was overshocked. Her nose was gone, her jawline shattered and rot. They said her baby was the reason she was holding on. She's dozing off, doctors getting no response. Her heart rate slowing down and they don't know what's wrong. Picked her up, got her out the home and onto the stretcher for good measure, but she's fading out. She took damage to the brain and now she's in a coma as we speak, but I ain't sure if she can make it out. You see, this time that I'm taking out to tell you the story is more than a song or track. It's a message to a woman with a toxic man. I'm begging you to get support if you're lost or trapped. I understand that I can never understand, and I ain't saying that it's easy, but it must be right. Some of your sisters, aunties, mums and wives are fucked inside and they will never touch on why. I'm touched cause I've seen women that I loved or liked cry a little red tear for a bloodshot eye. This shit's awful. No matter what culture, it ain't normal. Men try and twist it and make it seem like it's your fault. In that train full of people that you're taking, how many Lesleys are running from their Jasons?
Angel without wings, like the day without the night to bring a song without a voice, a spark without a flame, a child without a name. Oh, it's just wrong. Like an ocean without a shore, a soldier without a war. How can we do this anymore? A song without a voice, a spark without a flame, it's just wrong.
Well, we've made a massive amount of progress in this last year, haven't we? Feels like a long journey. And I must say it's been a pleasure to watch you mature and grow in thought and in your career and life. You've opened up immensely. I'd be lying if I said I wouldn't miss these sessions. But you know, you can never stop learning about yourself. So you're always welcome. I'm just happy you're at a place now where you feel you understand your emotions and are in control.